Hello children, welcome to this English class of grammar. The topic that I have for you is subject verb agreement, which is actually a grammar topic meant for classes 9 and 10. Subject verb agreement, my dear children, is often very confusing and people sometimes make a lot of mistakes in framing sentences related to this grammar topic. So I'm going to discuss the rules pertaining to subject verb agreement. Before I start the discussion, I would tell you about the structure of a sentence. A sentence, as you know, comprises of a subject and a predicate. The predicate has got a verb in it, and according to this topic, the verb which is there in the predicate must agree with the subject. There are many rules which govern the subject verb agreement, and I'm going to discuss those rules one by one. So let us start. The first rule says a verb must agree with its subject in number and person. This is a very simple rule, my dear children. It says that whatever verb that we are using in a sentence has to agree with the subject. How will it agree? It has to agree in number. That means the singular subject will take a singular verb, a plural subject will take a plural verb, and person, first person, second person, third person. So whatever is the person of the subject, we have to use a verb in that sentence according to the subject. This is the meaning of the first rule. There is an example given. The quality of the mangoes was not good. The meaning is that the quality of, we are talking about the quality here, and that's why we have used the singular verb was. Okay? Now let us discuss the second rule of subject verb agreement. The second rule says, it's given on the screen, two or more singular nouns or pronouns joined by and require a plural verb. The meaning of this rule is that if we have two subjects in a sentence, okay, if we have two subjects in a sentence and the sentence, the subject is joined by the word and, then in that case the sentence will take a plural verb. The meaning is you will have to use a plural verb with such a sentence. I'm giving you an example. The example is gold and silver are precious metals. Okay. There is an exception to rule number two, my dear children, and as learners, you need to take note of this exception, and you have to learn how to use this exception to the rule in a correct manner while writing and speaking. The exception to rule number two, which I have discussed just now, is if the nouns suggest one idea to the mind or refer to the same person, the verb is singular. The meaning of this rule, my dear children, is that if there are two subjects in a sentence, but both the subjects refer to one idea or one thing, then in that case, the verb used in that particular sentence would be a singular verb. For an example, the example is displayed on the screen. The example is time and tide waits for no man. Time and tide, same idea, same concept. That's why it takes a singular verb, waits. Now, let us examine rule number three. The third rule says, words joined to singular subject by with, as well as, etc. require a singular verb. This is a rule which says, I'm explaining the meaning of this rule. The rule says that if the subject or if the sentence construction is of such a manner that you have used with, you have used as well as in the sentence along with the subject, then in that case, my dear children, you have to keep this point in mind that the verb that you are going to use in that sentence will be singular. The example is displayed there on the screen. The house with its content was insured. The house with its content was insured. So we have, because the subject is house, whereas we have used with its content, so we have added with here in the sentence. So definitely we are talking about two things, house and its contents, but then we are using singular verb as per the requirement of this rule. Is that clear? Now coming to rule number 4. This rule states two or more singular subjects connected by or nor require a singular verb. Example, no nook or corner was left behind. So let us discuss the rule and the example together. The rule says that if there are two or more singular subjects, more than two singular subjects, and they are connected by or nor, then in that case the sentence will take a singular verb. Clear? The example is, no nook or corner was, it's not where, it's was left behind, singular verb. Okay? But remember, there are certain exceptions to the rules that we are discussing right now. So this rule also has an exception assigned to it. So let us discuss that exception to the rule. The exception is, but when one of the subjects joined by or nor is plural, the verb must be plural and the plural subject should be placed near the verb. So this is the exception. It means that if there are two subjects, one of the subjects is singular and the other is plural, then you have to place the singular subject first, and then you have to follow it up with the plural subject, and the verb will be plural and the plural subject will be placed near to the verb. Clear? The example is, neither the chairman or the directors are present. So chairman singular subject, directors plural subject, present. So that's why we have used the verb are. I hope this point is clear to all of you. Now let us examine rule number 5 of subject verb agreement. Rule number 5 says, when the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, I'm repeating, different persons, the verb agrees with the subject nearer to the verb. Now this is a complex rule. So it states that if there are many subjects there in a sentence and these subjects are joined by or nor, and these subjects are of different persons, first person, second person, and third person. Suppose there are two different persons, these subjects belong to two different persons. Okay, so in that case, what will happen? The verb will agree with the subject nearer to the verb. What will be the verb used? The verb will be according to the subject which is nearest to the verb. This is what the rule states. Example, either he or I am mistaken. So the example is either he or I, because I is next to he. That is why the verb that we have used here is am. We have not written are here. Are you getting me? So this is the sentence construction in such a case. But remember, it is always better to avoid such sentence constructions because they may prove to be a little misleading. That is why this rule number 5 is something which has to be used in a very careful manner. Okay? Okay, students, so let us come to rule number 6. The rule says either, neither, each, everyone, many, a must be followed by a singular verb. The rule is very simple, that when you are using either, neither, each, everyone, many, a must, all these verbs, if these are the subjects, if these words are used in a sentence, then it will be followed by a singular verb. The meaning is you have to use a singular verb there. Okay, the example. So let us come to rule number 7. The rule says two nouns qualified by each or every, even though connected by and, require a singular verb. The meaning is, if there are two nouns, two subjects, which are qualified by, qualified, something which is placed before the nouns. Okay? So, if there is each before the noun or every before the noun, then even though they are connected by the word and, it will still be a singular verb that will be used in that particular sentence. This is the meaning of rule number 7. The example is given there. Every boy and every girl was given a packet of sweets. Every boy, the noun boy is qualified by every, and girl is also qualified. Every is placed before the girl. So it takes a singular verb, was. Every boy and every girl was given a packet of sweets. Was. The singular verb is used according to this rule. Okay, so let us examine rule number 8. The rule states, some nouns which are plural in form but singular in meaning take a singular verb. The meaning is that these nouns, they look like plural nouns, they look like plural subjects, but they are actually singular in meaning. So such nouns, such subjects take a singular verb. Example, the news is true. News is, news looks like a plural subject, but it is actually singular, so it takes a singular verb. Now let us come to rule number 9, which says some nouns which are singular in form but plural in meaning take a plural verb. The rule is very simple. It says that there are certain subjects which look like singular but actually they are used as plural subjects in English. In such a case, we have to use a plural verb with them. The example is given. According to the present market rate, 12 dozen cost 100 rupees. So we are using the plural verb cost. Okay, 12 dozen cost 100 rupees. So this is how we have applied the rule here. Now let us examine rule number 10, which says none, though properly singular, commonly takes a plural verb. We are talking about the word none. It looks like a singular subject, but then it takes a plural verb. The example is given there. None are so deaf as those who will not hear. None are, not is. We are using the plural verb are here according to this rule. Now let us examine rule number 11, which is slightly complex. So I am going to explain it in a very elaborate manner. So let us examine the rule first. It says, a collective noun takes a singular verb when the collection is thought of as one whole. Plural verb when the individuals of which it is composed are thought of as plural. So the meaning of the rule is that if there is a collective noun used in a sentence as the subject, then if that collective noun is thought of as a plural subject, then the verb will be plural. And if this collective noun is thought of as a singular subject, then the verb will be singular. Are you getting me? For an example, the committee has issued the report. I have given two examples here. The first one is about the committee has issued the report. So what is it? It has taken a singular verb. The second example, the committee are divided on one minor point. The committee are divided. The same collective noun committee has been used as a singular subject and as a plural subject in these two examples. I hope I have made myself clear. Now let us examine rule number 12. It says, when the plural noun is a proper name for some single object or some collective unit, it must be followed by a singular verb. The meaning is very simple. It says that if the plural noun, if we are using a plural noun in a sentence, and if it is a proper name of some single object, okay, then we have to use singular verb in it. For an example, the Arabian Nights is still a great favorite. We are talking about Arabian Nights, which is a storybook, a very famous storybook. So the Arabian Nights is still a great favorite. We are not using Arabian Nights are, we are using a singular verb here. Okay, so that's the meaning. Let us examine rule number 13. When a plural noun denotes some specific quantity or amount considered as a whole, the verb is generally singular. The rule says that if there is a plural subject in the sentence, but it actually denotes a specific quantity or amount, then in that case, we will use a singular verb in that particular sentence. The example is displayed on the screen. 10 kilometers is a long walk. Okay, we are using the singular verb is, 10 kilometers. It looks like a plural subject, but is taking a singular verb according to the rule.